Hi, I'm Boosh, and today I'm going to be snowshoeing the Odena loop of the Voyageur Trail. It's about 4 kilometers long and brings you up to the Algoma Highlands. I'm going to be following yellow markers, which means it's a loop trail. Should be some fun. That was the access point I just did, so I can go to the Beaver Loop this way or the Odena Loop this way. I'm doing the Odena this time because it's fun. We'll be right back. Highway here. If I'm not mistaken, I think that's ruffled grouse. You kind of see little, I don't know if they'll show up in this thing, there's little claw marks. Not like paws. That's good, because they are delicious. Alright, so this direction here, that would bring me back to 6th line, which I'd follow back to my vehicle. And this way, the short little side trail that brings you to the lookout overlooking Sault Ste. Marie. And I'm going to check it out because it's kind of nice. Well, I can follow this road here east and get back to my vehicle that way, or I can follow this trail that goes parallel to the road and will eventually get me back to my vehicle as well. I'm gonna go this way, a little less traffic. I don't take my snowshoes off yet. I don't really take them off, kind of lazy. So I'm back at civilization, on the road now. Got my snowshoes on my pack, and I'm gonna walk along the road for about a kilometer and a half. I'm back in my vehicle. The sun's just starting to go down, and I have a headlamp and all that, but it's still nice to have daylight to get around the bush. But I had a great time. I definitely say the Odena Loop is a great snowshoe loop. I like it for hiking too, but snowshoeing's a lot of fun. There's some swampy sections that you normally see in the spring and the summer that aren't around this time of year because it's just frozen over and covered in snow. One cedar swamp in particular is a little vicious in the spring. Especially the bugs chasing you. So I had a blast. The lookout was pretty cold. I was going to have some tea up there, but there's just too much wind to use the stove, and I didn't feel like sitting up there for that long. So I'd definitely do this, make this a half-day trip. I started at 1, so it took me about 5 hours, and that's with me filming, going back and forth, and up and down a hill multiple times. Hills, I should say. The crust would be really nice to go on a snowshoe. Some of the packed path, you didn't even need it. I saw people walking around just in their boots. I'm a little heavier with the pack and everything, and snowshoe makes it so you have good grips too, because you have the size spikes on the bottom. But yeah, had a great time. Hope you all enjoyed it. There'll be more shortly.